number one way and the oldest way I make money is by selling music. I sell my own music and the music of my artists. And that includes downloads, streams, and physical records, like CDs. I have two record labels, one for electronic and one for orchestral / cinematic music. I chose my distributors carefully, and I've tried also few other distributors that I don't currently use, such as DistroKid, which I don't recommend. My current distributor delivers our music to all popular streaming platforms and download portals, and each month I get an analytic report of where and how the sales were done. If you check here, I made more than 1,700 euro from one individual track called We Are The Gods. Making money by selling music, it is considered a passive income, as if I stop releasing new music, sales and income will still be generated the following months and probably the following years for a long period of time. The important thing here is quality. I have seen many labels failing because of releasing a lot of tracks that nobody cares to listen. So if you want my advice, find or create tracks of extreme quality and do not focus on quantity. The second way I generate income is by licensing music. There is a huge difference between licensing and selling. When you license your music to someone, he gains the exclusive rights to use your music in a film or in a video game, and thus the payment is much, much higher than selling a simple download. Because when somebody is just downloading your song for 1 euro, he is not acquiring any kind of license. He can't use it for his advertisement or for his YouTube channel. For that matter, he has to gain a license from the rights holder, which is me, since I release my music through my own labels. Thus, I can set the price to whatever I think is reasonable. So the price for placing a composition of mine on a movie could be 2,000-3,000 euro. But then I lose the right to resell it. The buyer, of course, does not have the right to resell it also, but he might have the right to use it on a sequel. That all depends on what kind of agreement you settled on. Licensing your music is a very elegant way of making money, but it requires a lot of experience in order for you to realize what could be useful to the music supervisors, to the directors, and to media producers. But if you manage to figure out what kind of music, of audio, sells, you will be able to make a lot of money. Collecting royalties. Now, this is something most producers are not aware of. When you upload your music on, let's say, DistroKid, you do not get the neighboring or performance rights. those kinds of distributors don't collect your performance rights, which is the legal fee that you must get because your music was publicly performed or broadcasted. There are specific organizations called PROS, Performance Right Organizations, like BMI and ASCAP, that collect those rights for you. They have agents around the world who take notice of what kind of music is played live in concerts and in live venues, and they obligate those party promoters or those concert organizers to pay because they used part of your copyrighted material. And after collecting those royalties, they are obliged to pay the rights holder, the record label, and the record label is obligated to pay the artists. This is how things work. So most artists are unaware of those performance rights organizations and they don't collect their royalties. A very important source of income comes from affiliate marketing. I used to do blog posting and forum posting of links that lead to products, and if those products are sold, I get a commission. Nowadays, I do affiliate marketing with my YouTube channels. I have links in the description that lead to music-related products or services. And each month, those websites generate sales reports for each of their marketeers, and we, the marketers, get the commission of the products that were sold through our links. You could use Amazon affiliate program or ClickBank. It is a huge marketplace where companies post their affiliate programs and marketers choose a product or a service and they try to sell it. And in that way, they get commission. I host such affiliate programs on my own websites. YouTube has become an important piece of our lives. Everybody is using YouTube nowadays. It is the second most popular website in the world. The easiest way to make money on YouTube is to have a large amount of subscribers and thus a large amount of views, and ads are placed automatically by YouTube. Each month, the YouTube team generates a payment for you that will be transferred to your bank account. Making money on YouTube is one of the hardest things someone could accomplish. It requires a lot of luck because what we like does not always match the preferences of the mass. What you admire does not necessarily reflect what most people admire. So to create a channel, a vlog, whatever, that the people find as interesting as you do, it is a very hard thing to accomplish. When your channel gets big enough, you can also enable sponsorships or promote and sell your own products through your videos or through the description below. Selling services. I have made a lot of money selling services, such as Spotify playlist placements, audio mastering, audio mixing, remaking popular songs, and other activities that all fall in the same category. music production. I have used, and so can you, with great efficiency, platforms like Upwork, Fiverr.com. I've made a lot of money on Fiverr, SoundBetter.com, and others. Those are similar platforms where people sell services and get paid by hour or by delivery. The most difficult part on those platforms are your first deliveries, your first orders. The hardest part is for the first guy to trust you and make an order from you. And if you deliver successfully and you get a positive review and a high score, then things get easier and easier. Another way I make money is by reviewing tracks. Reviewing tracks is a service that you could sell on some platforms mentioned earlier, like Fiverr. But there are platforms specifically for this type of operation. There are platforms like Groover or Soundcams, where artists are looking for reviews and for promotion. So if you are an influencer, or if you have a Twitter account with 3,000 followers, or a SoundCloud with 5,000 followers, you could register on Groover or on Musosoup or on SubmitHub. I have tried them all and they are all fantastic and worth spending your time trying to make it. They have differences between each other. For example, Soundcams deals only with Spotify playlisting, while on Musosoup or on Groover you could get paid to promote a song through SoundCloud or even through your blog. If you have a blog, like a music magazine, you could just make an article, post the links of the artists and his music, and get paid for that. Reviewing tracks with the profound intention of promoting them is an amazing way of making money and at the same time helping young artists and providing some kind of value to the community. But in order to do so, you need scaled social media accounts. You can't do that with 200 followers. You need established Spotify playlists or iTunes playlists with more than 1,000 followers. Occasionally, I get donations to review and promote tracks. Selling your music in open source format. That translates to selling your music in FL Studio format or GarageBand format or Cubase format or whatever your DAW is, in order for new producers to be able to learn from your projects and consequently copy you. So choose wisely which of your projects you are going to share in open source format. There are plenty ways of doing that. You could just build your own website and use PayPal for the payments. You could do it on Patreon, as I did, or on Buy Me a Coffee. There are plenty websites where you can host your zip files for sale. Selling partitures. Now, this is something that requires studies of music theory. I have very basic knowledge of music theory, sometimes I get help by others in order to complete my music sheet, which is not perfect even then. It's actually very bad. But I am doing this for another reason. I'm not interested in making money out of my partitures. I am only interested in perpetuating my music. I want a group of people to be able to discover it after I die and play it in public. So I make partitures, scores, and hopefully someone will perform them in the future. You can use Sibelius, which is what I use, in order to convert your MIDI to PDF and vice versa. And then use arrangeme.com to sell your ready-made PDFs. The last way I make money is by selling my ebooks. I have written 2 ebooks so far, Music Talks 1 and Music Talks 2. They have 15 chapters each, and they are both about music marketing. If you are a young artist, a newcomer, I would certainly recommend one of these. They cost only 1 or 2 euros. And if you think that they are worthless, send me a message or leave your email below and I will send you a copy for free. I spent an enormous amount of time writing them, and a reasonable amount of money proof reading them. Those books include my testimony, 20 years of experience, and I started making money only the last 3-4 years. So by reading them, I assure you that you are definitely going to skip some years of struggle. Going through a struggle is essential and inevitable, except if you have the package and the big record labels discover you when being 10 or 12 years old, like Justin Bieber. But in that case, you've learned nothing and accomplished almost nothing by yourself, and your future might be sinister, because once you are at the top, there is only one way that you can take, and that is to go down. While when being down at the bottom, there is only one way that you could take, and that is going up. So the majority of those lucky ones find themselves 40 years old, baseless, with the ground shaking below their feet, because they skipped all that struggle and they found themselves at the top at a very young age. The music is not theirs, the lyrics is not theirs, the style is not theirs. They have stylists. They know nothing of promotion. They know nothing about marketing. They are Muppets, marionettes. On the contrary, if you climb the steps all by yourself, one by one, release your music, create your covers, promote your music, market your music successfully, make your own video clips, find the people that will place your music on their Spotify playlists or by yourself, find YouTubers that will upload your music. If you do that all by yourself, then no one can move you from your place. No one can take you down, because you found the way all by yourself, and even if someone pulls you down, you will find a way again and again. I'm not telling you all that to get the book. I don't give a shit if you take the book or not. 99.9 of the people that will watch this video will fail in the music industry. So that was it. I hoped I inspired you to take action.